guys, welcome to episode 4 of Good Vibes, Good Rides. Today we are going to be making this bike as blue as possible, painting as many parts as we can blue because I have this weird obsession with making things really blue. I don't know why, but we're probably going to be doing the handlebars blue, we're going to be doing the stem blue, we're going to try to do the shocks over here as blue as possible, although that one's a little bit sketchy. We're going to do the rims on this bike. We are going to do probably the cranks and the chain ring as well. And whatever else on this bike we can make blue, we're going to make blue. We're going to have to take parts off, spray paint them, and it's going to look dope in the end. And if I can do it, we are going to try and do the tires blue using blue plasti dip. We'll see about that one. So let's get to it. My face is up here. Alright guys, so we got the handlebars all set and off. We're gonna go on to the stem.
So here we have my favorite part, because it looks like body armor for a person. You see, we have the legs here, the torso here, shoulders, all it needs is a belly button.
Using this like lower grit sandpaper, we're gonna sand these, all these parts, just to give the paint a little bit more grip. So we're gonna get to doing that. So we're just gonna go get some masking tape real quick and tape these off, and that'll just be off camera. So we'll start painting. So let's go. Alright guys, it is the next morning, although it's like 1 o'clock, so it's not actually morning, but as you can see, all the parts are pretty much dry. So blue, so amazing. Gonna have to paint the underside of a lot of these because it's still black, but the parts that are painted look spectacular. Alright, so I think what we're gonna do now, while Nikki is at work, while I'm on my own, we are going to paint the underside of these and get a nice full coat on each of these parts. We also might go to like Joann Fabrics or something and get some blue like fabric or something, or leather, Nikki's idea, and put that on the seat. So yeah, let's get to it. Take apart the forks on the bike so that we can spray paint them outside. Let's get to doing that now. So now I think we'll just do the cranks and also the C-post clamp and then the forks here. And I think those will be the things that we do for today. But we're gonna start undoing these cranks now. So now that we have the cranks off, sand those down, clean them off, get them ready to be spray painted. And this chainring as well, have to be careful with this one, do like a nice light coat. But yeah, we're gonna spray paint this one, spray paint these, and then we'll do the forks. Yeah. Alright, so since it's getting so late and dark out, I'm just gonna go out and spray paint all the parts and everything. Then we're just gonna transition to tomorrow when it's all done and said and done and all that fun stuff. I am very tired right now and not very good at figuring out words to say. So, well, I'm going to bed soon after I spray paint these things. Bye. Alright guys, so it is day three, of the bike bluing process painting thing. That's looking pretty good. Petals are looking very nice. The color is consistent. But right now we're gonna go over to Walmart to get our plasti dip that we ordered online. And hopefully it's the right color, because I really want it all to match. I'll be back in like 2 seconds. It's pretty much the same color, so this might actually work. We'll see. The part that I just painted like 5 minutes ago, 10 minutes ago, it's pretty much completely dry. Color looks perfect. Maybe a little bit light, but like I said, that's fine. Kind of texture to it is actually almost perfect, probably. I think the rubber on the black side is more smooth than the rubber on the blue side. So I don't think grip is going to be an issue, which is one thing that I was worried about with the mountain bike tires especially. The only thing that I might be worried about is how quickly the blue wears off and how much I would have to repaint. But we're going to do another coat on this other side. And then later we'll do some testing with my BMX bike. We'll put this on my BMX bike and we'll test it out, ride around a little bit, maybe do some skids and stuff, and just see kind of the durability and the practicality of this painting method. And so I'm gonna spray paint this other side real quick, and then we'll see the finished product and start putting it on the bike. So see you then. Tire after a couple minutes of use. Not confidence inducing, but the fact that it does peel off makes it so that I don't really care if I get it on the mountain bike tires, because I'll just take it off if I need to. Looking good. Let's get to doing the actual bike now. So it is four or five, something like that. And we have all these parts here that need to be detaped. They'll be just like Christmas. And we'll see our nice painted parts. Right now I'm gonna get all this tape and paper off these parts. So let's get to doing that. just got the tires on and pumped up, and they're looking really good. Colors are almost an exact match. And now what we're gonna do is put the bike pretty much back together, and then we will have a fully blue bike, so. So, we just got the handlebars and the stem installed, along with the forks. It's looking pretty solid. And also, we'll get the grips and stuff on, pedals and all that. Hopefully, we can get that done today. But I am running low on battery, so we might just jump to everything being done. So, let's jump to that. In 3, 2, 1, the whole bike is going to be done. So, 3, 2, 1. Guys, so the bike is finally complete. I got the seat all set, got the handlebars, everything is blue, of course, that's the whole point. So now all that's left to do is to take it on the trails and do a little test ride, and then this video will be all set. So let's go do that. Alright guys, so it is the next day. The bike, with all of its blue glory, held up very well. Mostly rode the pump track over there, and it held up pretty well. There's like barely any damage to the plasti dip on the tires. Like no damage to any of the paint or anything. But overall, the bike is holding up super well. I don't feel any difference when I'm riding it either as well, so that's great. So I would definitely call this whole video a success, this whole process of turning my bike as blue as possible. And I'll definitely make an update video in the future to give you guys an idea of how long like the plasti dip on the tires lasts. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to drop a like, subscribe for more content. And as always guys, may your rides be as good as this outro is lame. And I'll see you guys.
Gone, and we're ready to go with the bug spray.
Great.